After losing 15 games in a row to begin the season with a record of 1-16, the Houston Rockets have now won 6 straight games. It's been a brilliant turnaround, accomplished due to a range of factors, as Houston becomes the first team in the history of not just the NBA, but also MLB, NHL, and NFL to win 6 straight games after a losing streak of 15 or longer. However, there's been one downside to this win streak. In the first game of the streak against Chicago, Jalen Green went down with an injury in the first quarter, and as a result, has not participated in the majority of these W's for the Rockets. In turn, some idiotic, unfair, and plain incorrect narratives are being generated about Jalen Green and how his absence makes the Rockets a better team. It is a blatant lie, to be completely honest, and I really didn't think there would be a need at all to discuss this, but some casual fans are going out of their way to call Jalen Green the Rockets' problem, when that simply isn't true. So, in today's video, I'll be debunking that lie about Jalen Green, and instead explaining the real reasons for as to why the Rockets are winning games lately to promote a more truthful narrative. Before we start, if you're new here and enjoy the video, be sure to subscribe. For more NBA content like this, I'd love to reach 18,000 subscribers on this channel by the end of the year, so all support would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, with that being said, let's talk about Jalen Green. Firstly, I want to explain why Jalen Green is not at fault for the Rockets' poor start and eventual turnaround since his injury. Statistically, Jalen's had gradual improvements in his rookie season. By no means has he been the standout rookie in this draft class early on, but he's still been very solid for the Rockets, averaging 14 points per game on admittedly poor shooting efficiency. But looking at the stats doesn't actually explain why he's been somewhat a bad player. Until this win streak began, Jalen Green was being utilized incorrectly by the Rockets, as rather than having him move off screens and make cuts to get him moving downhill, where he's at his best, Silas had him camp in the corner as a bailout option, often forcing him into late shot clock contested looks, which are overall very ineffective. That ended up with him having poor efficient shooting nights and declining confidence in his jump shot. However, that all changed against Chicago, as Silas finally ditched the two big man lineup involving Tyson Wood, which got players moving downhill more, in particular, Jalen Green. Jalen is way better when he's in transition, moving downhill and attacking the defense. As a result of this change from Silas, Jalen Green scored 11 points in just 11 minutes on elite efficiency from the field, on track for a massive breakout game. But sadly, he suffered an injury that's still keeping him out to this day. It was clear though that the Rockets had finally figured out how to maximize Green's all-NBA potential skill set, and that Jalen, along with the rest of the squad, would be able to come into their own. But again, since Jalen Green's sample size in this change of play for the Rockets is small, casual fans who don't actually watch the games have decided to create a BS narrative that turns Green into the scapegoat for the Rockets' failures, believing the Rockets' newfound success is because of his absence. Yes, factually, the Rockets are 2-16 when Jalen Green plays and 4-0 when he does not. But that statement lacks an enormous amount of context and turns Green into a scapegoat for Houston's struggles when that simply isn't the case. Some people may say, but Jalen Green had the worst box plus minus on the team before his injury, which apparently indicates that the team would be better off without him. But without trying to beat a dead horse here, the reason why Jalen Green has been objectively bad to start his rookie campaign, and in turn has had such a poor box plus minus through the games he's played, is because he was being utilized incorrectly. The lineup Silas ran initially through the first 17 games of the season held back Jalen Green enormously, as it also did for Christian Wood and Kevin Porter Jr. It didn't make a lot of sense to have Jalen Green camp in the corners of the court on an offensive possession, not get passed to unless needed for a bailout shot, nor have Christian Wood run alongside another big man in Daniel Tice. For Jalen, that led to him having to put up a lot of rushed, contested shots, and that's hindered his impact and efficiency early on. But against Chicago, however, in the better offensive system, he was way better before he got hurt, because Houston actually gave him the ball and got him moving downhill, rather than having him camp in the corner, like I said. Houston utilized him the way he should have been used in the first place, and as a result, he dominated. But to fit the narrative, people gloss over that fact. Yes, it's a small sample size, but it still proves that Jalen is not the problem. The offensive system and rotations at the time were. Saying stuff like, the Rockets were forced to diversify without Green, is so dumb to me, because it's just plain wrong. The changes Houston made to their system were already made before Jalen Green was absent. It's just that Jalen got injured at the wrong time to make it seem like those changes were made without him in the lineup, when that's not true at all. Jalen was there for the Chicago game and was going off. Again, that's when these offensive and rotational changes by Silas were made. To be quite frank, a lot of these wins in the win streak would have been blowouts for the Rockets had Green been playing, but people are going to look over that because it doesn't fit their hating narrative on Jalen. So, since it isn't Jalen Green's absence that has led to the Rockets' win streak, what are the real reasons behind their success? To me, these are obvious if you actually watch the Rockets, but a lot of people don't, to be fair, so they probably haven't realized these changes were made and instead have looked at Jalen's absence at face value. The first big reason why the Rockets are winning now is their offense is way better. There is way more fluidity on more offensive possessions each game, as Silas is implementing fewer isolation plays with KPJ, for example, and is getting better ball movement through off-ball and on-ball screening actions, cuts to the basket, and quicker passes. This has allowed for players on this team to get downhill more, such as KPJ and Green, which is where a lot of these guys are at their best offensively. This is resulting in much more opportunities to score inside the paint, more open three-point shots as their defense collapses around guys like Wood and KPJ in particular, as well as many lobs to the basket where the majority of this roster can finish with a dunk due to their superb athleticism. Silas has also been a lot better with rotations. He finally ditched the two big man lineup involving Tyson Wood, as I've mentioned, and as a result of that, the paint is a lot less clogged and the Rockets are getting inside a lot better now, also turning it over a lot less inside too, which as I've mentioned in a previous video, was a problem for them. Overall, things are a lot cleaner offensively. There are way less stagnant possessions that result in ineffective late shot clock heaves, and that's resulted in the Rockets having the 6th best offensive rating in the league in the past 6 games. Having Garrison Matthews come in has also been a major boost for this team, as his shooting and solid defensive abilities have been critical for the Rockets. The spacing he provides makes the offense a lot less congested for Houston. Christian Wood has also been a lot more assertive as well, and all in all, just a whole lot better lately than what he was when he played alongside Daniel Tice. The floor has opened up a lot more for him now. He can go on the low block and get inside, or stretch the floor. He's averaging 19.3 points, 11.5 rebounds, on ridiculous shooting splits of 52% from the field and 56% from deep in this 6-game win streak, with also 1.8 blocks per game to go along with that. He's starting to develop into a legitimate all-star since these changes to the Rocket system were made. But no, he's only playing this well because Jalen Green isn't sharing the floor with him. To me, it is clear to see that the Rockets are benefiting hugely from these changes made by Silas to the offense and rotations. Again, a change that was made before Jalen Green got injured. Overall, I just think people have to know that there's a lot more context to numbers and statistics than they show at face value. It's very easy to look at the fact that Houston is undefeated without Jalen Green playing and say he was the problem all along. But if you actually watch the games, you would see the bigger changes Steven Silas has made to the rotations, lineups, and offensive sets that has allowed Houston to be on the longest active win streak in the NBA. Jalen Green is not a bad player, not an ineffective player who chucks up inefficient shots. That is not on him, it's on the way he has been utilized. And as I've said so many times now, we all saw Jalen Green be utilized in a better way that maximizes his strengths at the start of the win streak against Chicago, the first game where Silas implemented his rotational changes. And guess what? Jalen Green was on track for 40 points in that match. The narrative that Jalen Green has killed the Rockets or is the ultimate problem for the Rockets is utterly ridiculous. And I hope today's video kills that idea, because as I've shown, that is simply not the case at all. And that will conclude the video. What do you guys think of this? Is Jalen Green actually the problem to the Rockets in your opinion? How do you think the Rockets will play when he comes back? Let me know all your thoughts down in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to drop it a like and subscribe. But with that being said, I am out. Peace. We'll be right back.